Columbia, Houston, good morning, and we understand your desires to get on through to the other side. We have some words on the situation when you're ready.
Okay, Houston, we're ready to copy.
And Tammy, it looks like the MMT just finished up, and we're still trying to gather their desires, but the sense right now is that EVAs are not going to be a player for this flight. We've got some OCA messages coming up to you, but we need to reconfigure the OCA data cable on the back of the PGSC, and I think we had some trouble earlier. And if you can reference TIPS message 70, that'll help us out.
Okay, Dom, we'll look for TIPS message 70. Thank you.
Columbia, Houston, we've just been enjoying the view as you went over the Marshall Islands. We think we saw Kwajalein, which has been doing quite a bit of the radar tracking for SPAS and some excellent work helping us keep the right geometry.
And we're looking at it too, Mark, out the windows. And if you have the opportunity, pass on our thanks for their support of this flight.
Okay, we'll do that, Taco. Thank you.
This is Mission Control Houston. At a mission elapsed time of 11 days, 6 hours, 13 minutes into the flight of Columbia, spacecraft communicator Mark Garneau briefly chatting with Commander Ken Cockrell aboard Columbia as the orbiter passes over a variety of island chains out in the Pacific Ocean, traveling in a northwest to southeasterly track at an altitude of 223 statute miles. Trailing Columbia by about 26 statute miles is the Orpheus SPAS satellite, the German astronomical platform, which has been flying free of Columbia for the past 11 days using a trio of telescopes trained on the heavens and key celestial objects to acquire data about stars and quasars and other interstellar medium. Orpheus SPAS is scheduled to be retrieved this coming week, the final major objective of this mission.